Passkeys are a new FIDO security standard that Google is now allowing you to use to sign into your account. So let me show you what that's supposed to look like, explain the setup process, and then we'll talk about the confusion that you and I probably both share about this. As I'm recording this, passkeys are only available for personal Google accounts, not paid workspace accounts. So I've logged out of both to show you the difference. When I log into my workspace account, I have to go through the regular verification method that involves providing a password and then verifying with my 2FA key that I've set up in the past. On my personal account, however, you'll see that process is simplified to require only my passkey verified via the touch ID on my computer. It's faster and, at least according to Google, a stronger form of security for most people. We're taking passwords and keys and combining them together in both function and name. It seems that passkeys are automatically generated for Android users, but if you have an iPhone or a desktop, here's what I had to do to set up a passkey. On an iPhone, you can log into your account either through your browser or Google's Smart Lock app, click on Security, and scroll down until you see the button for passkey. After I input my password, I click Continue, and you'll see that the only option I'm given is to save the passkey to my iCloud keychain. In the next month or two, we should have the option to save these to third-party password managers like 1Password. But right now, iCloud is the only option, and you have to have syncing turned on in your iCloud settings. Theoretically, this means that the passkey should be available for all of my Apple devices. So, for example, when I log into my laptop, I'm given this QR code that I can scan using the phone with which I've already set up a passkey. Now, strangely, I'm still being asked for my password, and I have a feeling that that's going to continue for a little while. And that may just be because this is the first time I'm doing it on this device. I don't know, but it seems to be a little counterproductive to me. It is possible to set up a passkey specifically for my laptop stored with my internet browser, which is Brave. Now, to do this, simply navigate to your account security settings or go to g.co/passkeys and then click the button to create a passkey. Unlike the iCloud passkey, this one will only be stored and used on this device. I can choose to use my touch ID or password, and then I'm done. Now, this passkey seems to be stored with my Brave browser, and according to my settings, is not synced between devices. So it's only good when I'm using this browser on this laptop. Now, there are a ton of questions you probably have about the use and security of these new passkeys, and I wish I had more answers than I do. But right now, I'm still trying to figure out all of this myself. What I like about physical 2FA keys, like those you get from YubiKey, is that they are offline and they're completely separate from my mobile device. And for that reason, I think and I really hope that these 2FA keys will continue to be used as a valuable form of login backup. But the value of the passkey for the average internet user is that passkeys make it much harder for you to grant access to your account to bad actors. I mean, it's possible to scam someone into sharing their username and password, but I can't share my passkey, and since it only works with the website or app that created it, I, as the user, no longer have to worry about whether I'm visiting a genuine website or a phishing site. At least, that's what they say. And for those who are worried that Google or Apple are going to hold on to their passkeys, it seems as though that won't be the case. First of all, both Apple and Google claim end-to-end encryption. That means that even they can't access the passkeys that you store with them. But if that's not enough for you, apps like 1Password will soon give you an alternative place to store and back up these passkeys. The goal is a future without passwords, and passkeys are quickly becoming an option for a number of online accounts already, not just Google. I mean, I still have a lot of questions and a little bit of confusion to sort out, so I'm not claiming to have all the answers here, but I do encourage you to leave your own concerns and comments in the comments, and once I do publish an updated video, you'll see that appear right here. For now, that's all I've got, so stay safe.